Yesterday, you discovered how to create the first line of your introduction that will immediately appeal to the audience and get them to want to hear more. So what's the next line that should go into that introduction? Give them a promise of what they're about to receive from you. So for instance, in my storytelling program, my second line of the introduction could say, "You're about to receive a 7-step repeatable process that you can use for any type of business story." Let's break that down. What I've given them is a specific number of steps, 7. Also, the word step itself is a concrete word that they can visualize. Words like steps, keys, or tools are much better to use in this type of introduction because those are things that people can actually picture. This may sound nitpicky, but concrete words like that stick with an audience better than terms like "you'll pick up new ideas," or "you'll increase your knowledge," or "these concepts." Those are not words that you can visualize. So give a specific number of steps, keys, tools that people will get. That helps them quantify specifically what they're going to take out of the talk. Again, it's all focused on them. You haven't said a word about yourself, and they're sitting forward and they want to know more. One of the biggest reasons this type of introduction stands out is because very few people do it. Now that you have the first two lines of your introduction created, you can transition into some mention of you, but will still be focused on the audience. How do you do that? Watch tomorrow's tip. See you then.